What's up, y'all? Sparty here, and I want to do my versus video between the Samsung Galaxy S7 and the LG V20. Now, I'm mainly doing this to test the performance difference between two phones that have the Snapdragon 820 in them, you know. Because in my, rigorous testing, I've noticed that the V20 does better in a lot of things where the S7 does slightly worse. So first, before talking about, you know, the overall, you know, verdict and shit like that, I want to talk about the build. This has an all glass construction, glass on the front and back, as well as, I'll just do it like this, as well as aluminum railing, aluminum buttons, and a home button. There's a 12 megapixel camera on the back with your heart rate sensor and your flash, your LED flash. You have your embedded fingerprint scanner and your home button. Let me turn this brightness down. Speaking of brightness, this is a quad HD Super AMOLED display. Why you don't want to focus, I don't know, but it's 5.1 inches. I'm not really sure about the pixel density, but you can figure that out for yourself. You can find that out anywhere pretty much online. I'm pretty sure it's like over 500. And it's pretty much it as far as it has an always-on display, which can also show your calendar and your time and your percentage and stuff like that. So, and that's pretty much it for the S7. That's a 12-megapixel camera, which has focus pixels as well, which allows it to, like, you know, focus faster in low light and whatnot. This is an all-aluminum body, except for the top and bottom, which are plastic for antenna and whatnot. You have your fingerprint scanner / power button on the back. You have your LED flash, your 8-megapixel wide-angle lens, your 16-megapixel normal lens. You have your color depth sensor and your laser autofocus on the back, your V20 branding. On the bottom, you have your speaker grill, your USB Type-C port, and your 3.5mm headphone jack and a microphone. On the top here, you have your other microphone and your IR blaster. And on the top here, you have your SIM card. If the phone will focus. You have your SIM card tray, you have your microphone, you have your micro USB, your speaker grill, and your speaker holes, rather, your microphone and your 3.5mm headphone jack. You also have two lines on the bottom and two lines on the top for your antenna. Yeah, Galaxy S7 branding on the back, V20 branding, your Verizon branding. You have your Samsung branding on the front. On the top front, you have your LG branding on the front, but at the bottom of the display. This is a 5.7 inch quad HD IPS LCD quantum display. That's a mouthful. Every 5-megapixel camera that can go from a normal to wide angle view. It's a wide angle camera. It crops when you go to your normal view. This is also a 5-megapixel wide angle front camera. This has IP68 water resistance. Could go up to, I think, a couple meters for like an hour or something. I'm not too sure. It works really well. I don't make it go farther than where that crack is because I don't want water to get into the phone, obviously. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Let's do the fingerprint scanner test. I fucking press. It's hard to do this because I have to pretty on par, but this is an always on fingerprint scanner on the V20, and on the S7 it's passive, so you have to press the button and hold it and it will unlock. 32 gigabytes of internal storage with micro SD card expansion up to 256 gigs. This has 64 gigs of onboard storage and micro SD card expansion that goes up to 2 terabytes, but since there aren't 2 terabyte cards yet, it's 256 gigs. You have your 3,200 milliamp hour battery in here. And you have your 3,000 milliamp hour battery in here. Now you would think that a 200 milliamp hour difference really wouldn't solve nothing, but due to optimizations, which Samsung claimed they had very good optimizations last year with the S6, or 2 years ago rather, with the S6, and lo and behold, they didn't. But the V20 is miles better with battery compared to this. Maybe it's Nougat that's helping it, maybe not, I don't know. But LG has always been pretty good with their batteries. I've always gotten at least like 6.5 hours of screen on time out of LG phones compared to Samsung phones, which I would get like maybe 3.5-4 hours, which is whatever. Fast charging helps throughout the day, so it's whatever to me. But let me talk about camera quality here real quick. On the S7, you have your, as I said, your 12 megapixel camera with focus pixels, 1.55 microns. That's how big the pixels are, with your f1.7 aperture. On here, with your 8 megapixel camera, it's a 2.0 aperture. On your 16 megapixels, 1.8. And honestly, people say that the S7 has better, you know, outdoor quality. I beg to differ, honestly. One does better than the other in certain situations. I get more consistent low light shots out of the V20 as compared to the S7. Not saying the S7 is bad. It's actually really good for a phone camera, but it's not the best. And now I'm going to go into performance. All right, so what I'm going to do first, I'm going to do it on here. As you can see, I exited the damn app and it still opened the app. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to open apps and then close them. You know, just in case you, just in case you select an app you don't want to use and you want to go into a different app. As you guys can see, sometimes it doesn't do anything. Kind of akin to I don't want to change the launcher. To my Xperia XA. I'll open some portrait mode games, and as you guys can see, it's jittering right there, and the phone doesn't want to lock focus, and I'll close apps. I'm not using the BlackBerry launcher, but okay. That's the S7, not the V20. No, not the... As I said, I'm opening nothing but portrait mode apps. In apps takes a while to load. That was settings. Wait, do I have two Amazon? I thought I had two Amazon links. I say, what the fuck? Yeah, I know I'm opening more apps on here just for fun, just to show you guys that even on here, the more apps that I open, I probably click get help and not what I wanted. His phone doesn't want to stay focused, man. See, look at that. You see how much more smooth it goes on the V20? When I open maybe like, I think, twice as many apps. But now I'm going to go into gaming real quick. And I'm not trying to like down the, you know, the S7 or anything like that. But as far as like, you know, screen brightness, the S7 wins. But honestly, day-to-day usage, they're both really good. Outdoors, they're really good outdoors. The S7 does win, but A, I'm using a darker wallpaper on here, and B, the S7 just has a brighter display. A display that's able to go brighter. But I'm gonna do some gaming here. I'm gonna open Future Fight. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna alternate. So I'll open Bleach. I'll open Bleach on the V20 and I'll open Future Fight on the S7. Then I'll switch it over. I'll do the V20. I'll do Future Fight on the V20 and Bleach on the S7. I know I've been doing the same quest all day. And don't take Future Fight loading a lot on the fucking S7 as the S7 being slow. Future Fight's not really well optimized on Android. So take that with a grain of salt. I'll go with this one. And this has a lot more stuff that it loads off the bat. But it still seemed to have loaded faster. Let me get these bastards out the way. And I'm not going to close any of the apps. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just... No, I actually kind of have to. Because they both do the thing where you have to be online on only... You have to be on only one phone. Or one device, rather. But as you guys can see, I'm not necessarily going to say the V20 is downright destroying it. Because it's not... But take notice as far as, like, you know. Which phone is playing the game more smoothly. But I'll tell you, my overall testing, the V20 tends to do a bit better. And I'll do this on here, on the V20, I'll do that, and I'll do, if I can do it again. If the boss didn't do a super, I'm pretty sure Bleach would have finished first, but it really doesn't matter. All right, so and as you saw right there, the V20 exited the app faster, despite there being a physical button on the, you know, on the on the S7. So, Do I just forget to turn my volume down? I'll just start it. You'll go with that network error shit. But I'm gonna play it. I'm gonna play Bleach on the S7 just to get it out the way. There ain't no network error if I just played the game on a different phone. Email. It's kind of hard to get both fucking phones in here. Sorry about that, you guys. I'll zoom in a bit. As you guys may see on the V20, Future Fight plays a bit better. And I don't have any like game optimizing modes on any of the phones. The only thing I really do have activated on my S7 is the game launcher, so that when you press the recent apps and back keys, it doesn't get out of the app, the game. But that's pretty much it. And I'll do the same test as I did. And as you guys can see, it plays pretty consistently compared to the, you know. Compared to the V20. Bleach is probably the more optimized of the two games. Future Fight's the least optimized. I got a character, huh? I'm probably gonna put him on one of my other characters, but whatever. So I'll take my S7 out of the equation. No, that's not gonna work. I have finished anyway. Sorry, I'm adjusting my tripod. As you guys can see, pretty much, the V20 plays Future Fight better. The S7 plays Bleach on the same, you know, in the same league, but not as, you know, optimized, I guess. That's not what I'm trying to say. I'm not trying to say least optimized, but less, you know, in a less... In a less smooth manner, it plays Future Fight, but it plays Bleach on par. But none of them reach my shield, honestly. But I mean, the V20 does, but it plays smoother on the shield. But that's pretty much it as far as the gaming side of things. Now I just want to talk about overall. With the S7, you get the best of Samsung. With the V20, you get the best of LG. Now on their respective sides, you get benefits and you get, you know, compromises. On the S7, you get this AMOLED display. On the V20, you get dual cameras and an IPS LCD display. For me personally, I prefer LCD. But not saying that I hate AMOLED, I don't. I love AMOLED a lot. I just prefer LCD because I prefer natural colors. That's pretty much it. But as far as which one is for you, if you prefer Samsung, go with Samsung. I'm not gonna knock you, but I will say, as far as heat dispersion and shit like that, the S7 is terrible when it comes to like heat management and staying cool. Like I recorded the same amount of like footage on my V20 as I did my S7 today. And the V20 stayed consistently cooler. I'm not gonna say it stayed like ice cold. It did get warm. But the S7, it got hot. It cooled down fast, but it got like HTC One M9 hot, and I can say that because I had the M9. This thing got hot as if I was running like Crysis 3 on it or something. Like I was doing some like super like I was writing software or developing a game on it or something. Like I was doing something that's demanding and taxing. When I was just recording a video. And I was recording it at 1080 60, sure. But the fact is that these two have the same processor. This one doesn't get as hot, but this one does. Now, it could be because this is aluminum and this is, excuse me, glass. But at the same time, Samsung needs to optimize their shit so it doesn't get that hot, you know? Because if you're gonna use glass on your phones, at least optimize it to the point where it can stay cool. It can stay cool for a consistent amount of time. That's all I'm asking for. I'm not asking for the world. I'm not asking for you to have Sub-Zero throw his ice ball at it and have it stay like that. I'm not asking for that. But for Scorpion to throw fucking to like, do his breathe fire move through his mouth and shit on this phone every time I do 10 to 15 minutes of footage on it, it's kind of weird because the V20 doesn't do it. And these two have the same processor. They have the same processor. It doesn't make sense. I kind of wish I had got the Exynos version because now I see what people are talking about, that the Snapdragon version ain't as good. Because of the simple fact that it's not as well optimized. Which, honestly, to spend another $800 on a phone with a different processor is stupid. You should wait for Samsung to optimize your goddamn phone. But for me personally, you can't go wrong with either of these phones. If you want a more optimized experience, go with the V20. And if you want to challenge yourself, if you want to make your photo, tailor your photos and your videos to look how you want them to look. Manual mode on here is superior in every way in the camera modes. This is a better auto camera. This is basically Samsung's, way of telling you we're no longer going to be the experimental company. Regardless if they did the edge display stuff and all that stuff, regardless if they started that, they're shooting for elegance, That's what they're doing with this phone. They did it last year too, they did. And it disappointed Note fans because they wanted a fucking beast of a phone. And the Note 5, as much as I love it, wasn't really a beast of a phone. It was a great phone, but it wasn't a beast of a phone. You could say the same thing about the Note 7, despite the fact that it blew up. But I just, that's a whole nother video. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. And have a good one. I'll be doing my more Shield stuff soon. I just gotta actually see what I wanna do with it. But yeah, as I said, that's pretty much it. This has been Sparta yet again. You guys have a good one.